welcome to a snapshot of the IT world brought to you in just 3 minutes, courtesy of the reporters at IT Examiner. There are 6 billion people in the world, and according to the reports, there are now 1 billion PCs too. That's according to the market research firm Gartner, which also believes that this figure will double by 2014. As PCs have been around since the early 1980s, a fair number of the billion have probably been junked. Gartner doesn't tell us how many of the billion use the Windows operating system, but if its number is correct, Microsoft has really cleaned up. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. And apparently, the world of the internet needs love too. ICANN, a body which decides which domain name suffixes should be used, has come up with .love, .hate and .city. Only the rich will be able to afford to Delhi with cupid.love or london.city, however, because it will cost you a whopping $49,000 to register this kind of domain name. Cops and clerks in the Punjab are to become computerized and link more than 600 police stations to prisons in a bid to make data accessible by the authorities. But it's not all just a matter of increasing efficiency. The prison department is set to provide skill development projects for prisoners to help them get gainful employment after they have been released. The authorities plan to give special help to young offenders and to women. Phone firm Vodafone is facing a mighty tax bill following its buyout of Hutchison SR last year. The company faces a decision by the Mumbai High Court on whether or not it will have to shell out $2 billion for the acquisition in back taxes. Vodafone is not happy about the prospect of losing $2 billion as the entire acquisition cost $11.2 billion. The company claims the deal was between two foreign-owned groups and outside the Indian tax jurisdiction. That's not how the taxman sees it here. The tax authorities reckon that capital gains tax is due because the assets are based in India, irrespective of where the two companies were established. People keen on gadgets and gizmos are likely to be less modest and more aggressive than your average human soul, according to a report by Nelson Online. It surveyed 25,000 American adults and concluded that wealthy young males are likely to have more leadership qualities than those who don't own gadgets, and also more likely to associate themselves with brand names, status symbols, and luxury goods. The results fly in the face of conventional wisdom, which associates gadgets and gizmos with geeks, introspection and lack of social skills, and an aggressive streak. Thanks for being with us. For further updates, please log on to itexaminer.com.